Thanks for purchasing Hot Rod, the brass version. Let's check it out and see how it works. What you're gonna get is the actual brass hot rod here and these two white blocks. Now you'll notice if you look at the hot rod, you've got a little brass coming out on that side. When you push it in, the colors will change from colors to red. Same thing on the other side. This side will turn blue to red. Now what these white blocks are for is so you can reset the gimmick. Simply take the blocks, put the hot rod inside, close it up like this, and you have a long end here. One's a little longer than the other side. Take that long side to the table like so, and give a few taps. Now, when you do the taps, you should get blue on one side and colors on the other side again, because the inside will come out just like so. It's the main secret, but this is good. Put the bang ring aside. Of course, this is out of view when you perform. When you're out about 1 inch and the colors are showing on one side and the blue is showing on the other, you're ready to begin. Now, let's go over the paddle move. This is the essential move used for the hot rod. Simply hold the brass hot rod like this, kind of like you're going to poke your spectator, but don't do that. Hold it just like this to your right and roll the stick over. You've got the colors showing up. Just use your thumb here along your fingers to roll it like that. Okay? This is the first step in learning the paddle move. And you're going to combine that action with the action of turning your wrist up like this. Palm up to palm down, showing the other side. Of course, you're going to roll at the same time and you get this. Colors on one side, colors on the other. Okay, I'll do that again so you can see. Colors on one side, I'm rolling the stick as I turn it over. Two actions combined. Okay, practice this move, because once you have it, you're ready to do the trick. It should look like there's colors on both sides when you do the move. Just like that. Now have the spectator pick any number 1 through 6. It doesn't matter what number they pick, you're always going to make them land on blue. Very nice force here. You're going to force blue. If they said 1, you're going to have them spell 1, O-N-E, that gets them on blue. If they say 2, you're going to have them spell 2, T-W-O, that gets them on blue. Or they can count from black, 1, 2, and they get on blue. 3 is simply 1, 2, 3, that gets them on blue. 4 is from this side, 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, they can spell it, F-I-V-E. Or if they say 6, you can have them spell it from this side, S-I-X. So they will have been fooled thinking that they picked any color. However, you haven't picked a number. Now this is very deceptive, but let's keep going. Once you have them land on blue, by their own free choice, so to speak, what you do is a paddle move one more time. Show the colors and say, since you picked blue — they didn't really pick blue, they picked a number, but say that. Since you picked the color blue, I'll just take my hand over and make the colors change to blue. Of course, all I'm doing is the same roll, just like that, while my left hand covers the stick for just a second. Now, of course, if you're left-handed, just reverse the hands and you should be exactly fine. You should be just fine. Now, let's do that one more time. Colors. Now, sir, since you landed on the color blue, simply take my left hand, give a little wave, and you get blue. Of course, the big action of your hand coming over covers the small action of rolling that hot rod over. All right? Now, once you change in blue, you can set up for the paddle move once again to show that not only did this side change, but this side changed as well. Very deceptive, because they're seeing both sides. Now, at that point, you can change the colors back by doing the same color change that I did before. Wave over as you roll. Do the move and say, this time, sir, pick another number. Or if it's a lady, you can say ma'am. But this time, a spectator picks another number. And go the other way. You can use the same force, but this time you're going to make them land on red. All right? Roll the stick like that. And once they land on red, say, okay, this time you picked red. Take your left hand, turn it right over the hot rod here, and with your left thumb — let me turn around so you can see — with your left thumb, you're going to come over and simply push the gaff inside, just like this. And that same action, push the whole hot rod out of your left hand. This engages the gaff and everything is clean. You can take it out, show it this way, you can push it through one more time for effect, and show that the other side has changed. This is basically divergence through the fist flourish, but you're pushing in the gimmick at the same time. Once you've changed to red, simply turn the stick over this way to simulate what you did before, the paddle move if you like. Then you can cleanly show that not only is this side red, but this side is red as well. And people that think they know how the original hot rod works will be fooled because of this gimmick. Now, of course, when you want to reset, take your pieces and reset. Of course, do it away from the spectator, but you're ready to go again. And this is a really cool trick. So practice it, work on resetting it, and practice the paddle move. Because once you get that down, you've got yourself a little miracle that you can keep in your pocket and you'll enjoy. So thanks again for purchasing Hot Rod, the Brass Hot Rod, and we'll see you next time.